temperature sensor. Can you see that screen? Can you see this screen? Yes. Now, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, fine. So, a program is written on some online compiler, you type this. What you can do, you can use online compiler here, and in this program JED, click on this. Click on this. You will get this. Now you type this and observe the output. Any person is facing difficulty to get the online compiler? Now, Shobhit, you do various experiments with this. Try various other programs, use more than one fork. After println, you write another print statement and do experimentation and try to find out what does fork statement do. You may also try a loop around fork and println. Is it correct? And try to find out what it does. And others should also type the output and somehow try to conclude what each fork statement does. Altaf, you are also correct. Are they not coming in the same different line? Siraj? Yes, you are correct. Can someone give the reason why K is printed once and why L is printed two times? Try to find out the reason. Any person got any difficulty in executing this program? Then tell me, I will help you. Any person who has not got this output? Any person who could not execute it, type in the chat, what does fork statement do?
Sir, you need to scroll down.
Oh, yes. No. Sodeep, in no compiler you can get this answer. Tell me what program you wrote. Probably you have put fork statement before print K. Sohbera. No, others, it is not correct to say that after the fork two child process. You should not say two child process. You should say two process. One main and one new child, one child are created, exist. One main was already created. No, Sahik Hussain, you are wrong. The control again goes back to fork. No. Creates a child process, fine, I can understand it. Creates a new process, I can understand it. But what is the need of writing? And you are getting two K's, which compiler are you using? Which compiler, what is the name of the compiler? GCC. Can you use this compiler? C online compiler PROGRAMIJ. Use this. Yes, a new process is created, which is a copy of the part of the program after it, which is a copy of the program after it. Not part of the program after it, complete program after it. Which compiler is this website using? That I do not know. Online C compiler, you will find online editor, you will find programage. So use programage. I don't know which compiler has been used. Sohat Behra. Sarvadeep Behra. Sarvadeep Behra. Which online compiler gives KL KL? I think you have removed slash n. Harshvardhan, are you using slash n? Yes. So basically, what does fork do? It makes a duplicate copy of the program for the time being. And from that point onwards, both the program execute independently.
हेलो कौन था साढ़े चौबीस से तो बनाया साढ़े नहीं साढ़े चौबीस साढ़े पच्चीस बताए साढ़े पच्चीस तो ऊपर रिकॉर्ड किया ना
We shall see it later, Harshvardhan. As such, without new line also it can be done. It has nothing to do with process, it has to do something with buffer. Is it correct? Yes. So do you, is the definition of the fork is clear to you? Any difficulty in the definition of the fork? We can remove slasher also. And observe the output. Technically speaking, there is a duplicate copy of the program, entire program. And both the programs start executing from that point. Juman, I am explaining it once more. As such, one can think that a duplicate copy of the entire program is made and both the programs resume their execution from that point only. Is it correct? Yes. But truly speaking, duplicate copy of the program is not made. Duplicate copy of only program counter is made. Program counter stores the line number which is to be executed. So duplicate copy of the program counter is made. So both the programs start executing from that point only. Is your doubt clear? So in this way, you can get the output in the same line also. Excuse and as Vaswan was saying, that we can remove F plus, then some other output comes. What is the problem? Someone was speaking.
Yes, sir. So, so if it is duplicating this program, it will be some kind of an infinite loop, right?
Why it is infinite loop? Because fork is executed only once. So once the duplicate copy will be made. We are not executing fork inside a loop.
No, sir. Like what I was thinking is fork will create a copy of this, which will be having a fork again, right?
That will be fork again. But you see, both of them will start executing from the print FQ statement. Do you understand it?
Yeah. Okay.
It will not make any difference. And as Gyan has asked, what is F plus STD dot out? It has to do something with buffer. And buffer concept we shall be teaching sometimes else. Once we execute print P statement, P is not immediately written. It is put into buffer. And buffering we shall teach sometimes else. Any more doubt? All people have got the output. Any person faces difficulty in executing it? But as I was like to tell you that the copy of the program is not made. Who asked me the last question that infinite thing will be created? Copy of the program which is not made. Copy of only program counter is made, PC is made. So I want to know the name of the person. If he is my old student, he may be knowing what is a program counter.
Sir, I was the one, Ajwad. I was the one asking that.
What is your name?
Ajwad, sir, Ajwad.
Ajwad, this very, who was asking a lot of questions in the theory also, huh?
Yeah.
Ajwad Jaina Juman.
Yes, sir.
That is correct. Because you don't know what is program counter. As such, when a program runs at the machine level, then there is one variable which stores which line is to be executed next. And when that line is executed, it gets updated or incremented, unless there is a jump statement. And only that copy of that particular variable is made. So now there are two such variables which store which line is to be executed next. So two times the same line is getting executed. Is this correct?
Sir, can you repeat?
Who are you?
Shobhit.
Again, you are not my old student. You see, there is a program which is a sequence of statement. Initially, statement number one is executed. Why? Because the value of PC, program counter, is one. When a statement is executed, the value of PC is incremented. So the next statement is executed. So this is how the execution goes on. Unless we have got some jump statement, then the PC value is abruptly changed. So when there are two PC values, so two statements are getting executed. If the two PC values are the same, then the same statement is executed two times. Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes. That was not so important to understand complete thing, but still I told you because there are most of my old students are old students. Okay. So I am switching from this program to the next program. Yes, you are fully correct, Juman. You are fully correct. Is it correct? Now you execute this program and get the output. From this point onward, we will differentiate between a process and a program. Not garbage value, some number is coming. Don't say garbage value. And you execute it once more and see what is the output. That is correct. Harshvardhan, you are simply correct. No, something related to time lapsed wrong. Some integer you should say. Nothing is related with time elapsed. That is correct. It is a process ID. Darshan, you are fully correct. Yes, because I have not taught you the concept of buffer, and rather in this class no one knows what is a buffer, but teaching the buffer will take one or two more different lectures, so I don't want to get diverted. So after every printf statement, either you use slash n or you do not, or you use f flush std out. But still, if you are interested in buffer, then sometimes else I can teach you, and I will be teaching to the entire class also. Juman, it was for Juman. No, a constantly increasing integer is not correct, Hussain. It is not correct. Reason is this: program is the same. But a program executed two times means two different processes. So we get a different number. No, wrong. Aditya, Hussain has written wrong. A constantly increasing integer. Actually, no. If you run many times, yes. Aditya has written, said it correctly. It is not constantly increasing. Yes. It has changed and decreases also. Is it always increasing?
Sir, it sometimes decreases also.
Who is speaking?
Sir, Aditya Singla.
Aditya Singh, no, but I am finding it is always increasing.
Sir, I ran a couple of times, I ran 4-5 times. It changed from 4-digit to 3-digit. 3-digit ID after some time.
Yes. That is correct. So basically, what is getPID? What is the meaning of getPID? What is its meaning?
Sir,
but up, speak.
Sir, how this, like, what is the sequence? How this PID is allotted? Like this process ID is allotted.
You see, it is one program, yes or no? There is only one program. When we execute it two different times, there are two different processes. What is the difference between program and a process? A program is process under execution. Sorry, a process is program under execution. So different instances of the same program running are two different processes. Is it correct? What is your problem? And get PID is get process ID. So we get a process identifier. So any process, any execution instance of a program is a process and it has got a number. Now tell me your doubts. Certainly, it may be having some range, but I do not know about its range. Is it correct? Yes. It can certainly not go to any limit. Chetej? Now, let us further see. Observe the output of this program. Okay, good thing which you have suggested. Let me see what it is saying. Difference between program and process. When we execute a program that was just compiled, what is the need of writing just compiled? It could have been compiled 1 year back. The OS will generate process to execute the program. Execution of the program starts via GUI. Okay. Process. The term process refers to the program that code that has been loaded into a computer's memory so that it can be executed by central processing unit. A process can be in the program running. Yes. Now you execute this program and observe its output. Execute and understand its output. Certainly from the previous knowledge, when getPID is not there, percentage D is not there, then what output do you expect? And now what output do you expect? Observe the difference. Thank you. what are you writing like this? Oh, 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 because the problem is that I have not put slash n. I forgot one thing. That is correct. A is getting printed two times because of the buffer. And as I have told you that after every print, put slash n. I forgot. Now observe the output. U is printed only by the main process. Yes, it was because of buffer. Without slash n, the output was duplicated because of buffer. That is correct. You are fully correct. From where you have read the name, child process name?
Sir, I was reading an article.
That is correct. Who are you? Are you a mathematics department student?
No, sir. I'm Aditya Singla. I am economics student.
Aditya Singla, na?
Yes, sir.
That's good. You are correct.
So, like after running, I'm also sometimes searching articles and reading more.
Very good. So U is printed only by the main process. And what fork does? Fork makes a child. Makes another process. P is printed by both processes. Now let us run it. So you see, what is main process here? In this current circumstances, what is the main process? Our program is this and our output is this as coming out on the screen.
So 4753 is the main process and 4754 is
new process.
Yeah.
Is it correct? Yes or no? Who are you speaking? Okay, so you type what is the main process and what is the new process.
So this new process is only due to the forking, right?
That is correct, fully correct.
Mm-hmm.
It took birth at the line number 2.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
So, sir, now we see that when we run the using the fork, the child process ID is just next to the main ID, but
no,
when
it is
we...
not correct. Not it, it. It need not to be correct. We can see later on that it may not hold all the time.
Is it correct?
Okay, because the question was stemming from that fact only.
That is correct. Okay, we shall see. You remind me. Maybe that if I don't solve it within 1 hour, then you remind me about this. Is it correct?
Okay, sir. Thanks.
Yes. Because you see, the child is created immediately. Hence, it is coming one number higher than that. So let us see, do something so that child is not created immediately. You see the difference here now? Can you see the output? Others, main process is 689 and the child process is 713. Can you see this? Yes. Who was speaking about this, that child process is plus one?
Sir, I was asking.
What name?
Aditya Singla, sir.
Aditya Singla. Now it is clear to you? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Because you see, that time what was happening, immediately after the creation of the main, the child process was created. So only a difference of one was coming. But when there is a sufficient time gap is there, then many other processes may be created. So something else may come. Is it correct?
Yes, sir. I also wanted to join that to the fact that when we ran only one process and then we ran the output again and again and we're getting the different IDs, there was substantial difference in the ID numbers. So that
No. Where? Most of the time, the difference was of one only.
No. Not in this program, sir. Like much before in our class when we just used the GetBit ID for the first time.
That is correct. Yes.
So because the ID was changing quite largely, I thought that perhaps other processes might be running after we compile one and then we again run the compiler again.
That is correct.
So that was I was joining to.
That is correct. Any doubt till now? Any person has any doubt? Mostly yes. Chitish, I also find that it is always greater than the parent. Is it correct? Mostly. Sometimes we shall be running these programs in the Linux environment also. With whether any of you have got Linux environment or Unix environment or Fedora or Ubuntu. If you have it, then try to run these programs in those systems and see what happens. No, GetBit and fork works in every compiler. No, it is not correct. You try to execute it in a code blocks or Turbo C, it will not work. It will not work. Because GetBit, fork has nothing to do with C programming. It is a part of Linux operating system calls. Yeah, we have to think about it. Others, whatever you are saying is correct. Yes. Okay. Others, do you have got some other like Linux or Unix or Ubuntu or Fedora? Do you have got that? Unix. Try to run them in Unix, Juman. That is correct. They are not getting compiled on Windows. So you use online compiler. Nilanjan, In that case, use online compiler. What are you saying, Juman? But fork is not running. Fork is certainly running in Unix. It will run. You run it. Okay, fine. So what output are you getting in engine? So fine, you should be happy. Previously, you were saying that you are not only getting the output. Fine. This is, Juman, I cannot understand it, what you are saying. Once you have an error, then how you can get the output? On which compiler are you using?
Sir, when I ran, I got this error when I ran in Unix, and I was running the program to get the output in online only, like the program is on.
In Unix? Unix, yes. Compiler? So how you was running in Unix compiler? Have you done the partitioning of the disk?
No, you, sir. The,
Unix, but it is not Unix. How you got Unix?
I'm using Mac OS, actually.
Macro?
Mac OS, sir.
I cannot understand it. Because you see, why they are not coming in Windows? Windows is using Turbo. And getpid and fork are system calls. Mac OS is the Mac OS is Unix. Now, as I was answering the Nilanjan question, that these are nothing to do with C programming. These are system calls based upon operating system. And Windows is a different operating system. It is using a different operating system. Is it correct? Yes. Any doubt till now? That is correct. System calls are OS dependent. What has happened to it? Execute this program and observe its output. Yes, is get t feed is valid. Yes, yes, it is valid. It is valid. No error in this. Yes, fine. And others will also be doing it, and we shall try to understand what various numbers are. But we shall do it after 5 minutes break. Correct. After 5 minutes break, we shall be talking about. Five minutes break.
Thank you.
now we begin again. Yes. We have already seen what is the meaning of get process ID. Another thing is get get process parent process identifier. Yes. So let us execute it. And observe the output.
Sir,
just wait. Now, batao, what is your question?
So, for like the first process itself, it's showing some parent ID, right? What it meant to?
Dekho, whatever is coming with H. H is printing the main process ID and the parent of the main process ID. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
So what is main process ID from my computer? Main process ID is 15776. Is it correct? Who is the father of main process? Bolo. Who is the father of main process? Yes, 15769. What is the problem? Any problem?
So, like each and every process will be having a parent ID.
That is correct. Every process will have a parent. Main process parent is 15769. And the main process itself is 15776. Is it correct? Fork has created a new child process. Yeah, I also don't know why it is happening. I am seeing it is happening, but why it is happening that I cannot say. Is it correct? Yes. Technically speaking, Nilanjan, parent of the main is the window in which this program is executing. But if it is so, then when we execute the program different times in different same window, the parent process should come out to be the same, parent of the main should come out to be the same, but it doesn't come out to be the same. But if you execute it in Linux environment or Ubuntu or Fedora, you will find that the parent of the main is the window in which it is executed. You change the window, parent of the main changes. Otherwise, only main changes, but parent remains the same. Is it clear to you, Nilanjan? You can experiment these things in some other Linux or Fedora. Yes.
Yes, Gyan has asked a very good question. How p-print of the child process is coming out in one in some cases? Very good question. And how to get rid of it? Can you tell me at present, a new process has been created. What is the new process and what is father? We shall come to it. Yuvraj, we shall be coming to it. First of all, let us be clear with one thought. Then we shall be coming to this. At present, what is the happens when fork is applied to the main? Fork creates a child process. Fork creates a child process. Can you tell me what is its identifier? Yes, Juman is also correct. A child process is what? Child is 15777. This is our child. Who is the father of this child? Who is the father of this child? Certainly, 15776 created 77. So 76 and 77 are father and child. Father of the child is main? Yes. Any doubt? Correct. It is main. Any doubt till now? Any student has got any question, and one doubt has to be asked. No, return statement has nothing to do with this. No, return statement has nothing to do with this. Is it correct? That is a very good thing. What is the answer of the Gyan's question? At present, we have got this output. Now, let us run it once more. Main is 374.
child is 375. Child's father is 1. Which process is associated with 15769? The father of main. Who is the father of? Father of main is 15769. Father of the main is 15769. This is associated with this. Is it correct? Yes. Yes. Technically speaking, Abhiraj, the parent process of the main process signify the window in which it is running. Is it okay? But it has got some inconsistencies in online compilation. Any question till now? Here, main is 374, child is 375, child's father is 1. We shall try to understand why is this happening. That is correct. It is really possible that main won't be the father of his own child. It is possible. How? How a person cannot be a father of its own child? I think yes. Swapnil? Yes. I think one stands for that. You are correct. I think. What is a father of a new child? How a person cannot be a father of a child? Father produces a child. And after some time, the father dies. So the child is adopted by someone else. So even if a person has produced a child, the child's father is not the old father. And now we shall see how this actually happens. We shall see to it. I think so. No, Nilanjan, when we execute these programs in the lab of our department, then on some system it is and on some other system it is not. On few systems it is. One is default parent process ID for process with no current parent. Yes. On some systems which are executed in Ubuntu or Fedora.
Now, let us observe. The output of this program. Who is main program is written here. Our program is here. My question is, who is main? Art is main's father. What? Who is child? What is child's father? These are the questions in which we are interested in. I have also asked this one question. Child's father is 906. You are 50% correct. Das Gupta. Child's father 906. You are 50% correct. You see, main is 906. Main's father is 899. Who is child? 907. And who is 907's father? You see, 907 has got two fathers. 907 has 906 or one as father. That is correct. Hussein, you are correct. Because child is now adopted. You see, so bhit, why only one is assigned? In our online compiler, one is assigned. But if you are using Linux environment with Ubuntu and Fedora, then it is not the case that only one is assigned. Something else can also be assigned. Is it correct? Yes, it can be assigned. What else is your doubt? Ask your doubts. You see, at time t equal to 0, h is printed and first k is also printed. At time t equal to 1, after printing t, every process dies, and at time t equal to 1 only t is getting printed. So what happens? It depends upon who prints first, father or child. If father executes fast and prints its own t, the child will not will get its old father. What is the problem? Now ask your doubt, and of course I will be explaining this with some other examples also. But at present, try to ask your doubts. I will really tell to you how the father dies. Is it correct? I will tell. I will tell, but let us ask more doubts related with this. Yes. You see, the statement of T is executed both by parent and child at the same time. So it is a race condition. Whether parent executes it first or whether child executes it first. No, that has nothing. No, I don't think that anything has to do with return zero. No, I don't think that anything has to do with return zero. No, it is not the case. Okay. I am not saying that everything will become clear now. Dhruv, what is your problem? Are your problem is related with adaptation only or something else? We shall see to it. The concept of return zero, we shall be seeing to it. But for the time being, let us try to understand as many things as we can understand now. Later on, we shall see properly. But at present, let us see as much as you can understand now. Yes. Sleep 1 executes the program for 1 second. We shall see to it. Tell what the above program No, that is also not true, Gyan. No, it is not correct. If we remove sleep, then parent process will be completed first. No. If we remove sleep, then 2 times 1 can come by child. And if we put sleep, then at least 1 time true father is guaranteed. Because why? When this sleep is there, it gives you guarantee that the parent will die only at time t equal to 1. So at time t equal to 0, child's father will be the old father. Is it correct? So whatever Gyan is saying is wrong. Now at present we are seeing the concept of sleep. What does this given program do? ABC is all right, but time is important here. You see, B does not come immediately after A. Some time lapse is there. Can you see this? That is correct. Process is blocked for that period. It is blocking. Process is not getting executed. Even if CPU is available. Okay, I don't want such a high level concept you should apply to the lab, but whatever you are saying, Abhiraj, is correct. Sleep changes process state from running to blocked. And this block is at least for that much time. Is it correct? So what does this program output? This program outputs t equal to 0, our output is A. T equal to 3, our output is B. T equal to C, T equal to 5. T equal to 3, our output is B. T equal to 5, our output is C. Any doubt? Any doubt till now? Yes, when we use fork, the child process is theoretically running parallelly. Theoretically. Is it correct? It is theoretical parallel, but practically concurrent. We are assuming that different processors are executing parent and child theoretically. Is it correct? Yes. Any doubt related with this here? Then we come to the next thing.
Excuse me, sir. Yeah. Sir, after we use fork, so the statements after that in both parent and child, they can be executed in any order, right? It doesn't have to be that first.
In any order, but later in the later program, we shall try to control their orders.
Okay, sir.
For the time being, they can be executed in any order, but even that is also not correct.
Okay, sir.
I will explain to you now. Who are you speaking? You see,
Pranav.
At time t equal to 0, h is getting executed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
At time t equal to, and after that time t equal to 0, only two k's are getting executed, one by parent and one by child.
Yes, sir.
And they can be executed in any order. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, the statement of the t will be executed strictly after statements of k. Yes?
Yes, sir. That was because we put sleep in there, right?
Sleep one. That's correct. Of parent and child.
Okay.
But if we remove this sleep, if we remove, then technically speaking, the output can be kt, kt also.
Okay, sir.
The statement k of parent or child can be executed by the statement t of the child or the parent. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is correct. But theoretically speaking, once we put this sleep, kt statement cannot be any in any order. First, both statement of k will be done, then the t will be done. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But among the t, there can be any order. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Who are you?
Sir, I am Pranav.
Okay, yes. Roll number 40?
Sir, 18MA 33.
33, yes.
Sir, one more doubt. Sir, can you briefly repeat this concept of adoption?
We shall be repeating it.
Okay, sir.
We shall be repeating it in great detail. For that, we are creating the background.
Okay, sir.
Is it correct? Yes. Adoption basically means, you see, when K will be printed by its child, what will be its father? True father? Yes or no? Pranav?
Sorry, sir. Come again.
I am saying when K will be printed by child, K will be executed by child, it will try to find its father?
Yes, sir.
Which father? True father.
Sir. Yes, sir. True father.
Reason is this. It will try to find its father at time t equal to 0 and the fathers died at time t equal to 1 only.
Yes, sir.
But when child is trying to execute T statement, it may get its true father or it may not get its true father.
Okay. It there's a chance it may get the true father if the father hasn't executed its T statement.
That is correct. That is correct. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Except adoption, everything is clear to you.
Yes, sir.
That is correct. We shall be coming to adoption in Monday, but at present it was randomly one and randomly non-one. But later on we shall really control that it must be one or must not be one. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, we shall see to it. Can you tell me what will be the output of this particular program? You see, what is the value of A?
what is the value of A, 5, in the main program? Do you agree? When duplication is done, then what value is given to A and B?
A will be getting some garbage value.
No. When duplication is done, then all variables are of main are copied into parent. Who was you speaking?
Ajwat sir.
This new person. Okay. No, it is not correct. Except the process ID and few more things. Is it correct? For the time being, you assume that when duplication is done, all variables are duplicated. Except your own ID and your parent ID. And later on, we shall see one more thing. Is it correct?
Okay, sir.
So value of A will be the 5 only in the child. Execute it and see. And the value of B will be different. That is correct. Others should also be doing it. Any doubt? A is 5 in main and we can observe its output. A is 5 in main, process ID is 7182, and when duplication takes place, the value of A is duplicated. And value of B is different in both of them. Yes. Very good thing which you have asked. They don't have access to the same location. Duplicate copy is getting done. Is it correct? Can you create an example to show that they don't get access to the same location? If parent changes the variable, its changes are not getting reflected by the child. Okay, create an example. You see, when you will use address A to check, you will find that they are the same. But physically, they are different. Even though addresses are coming out to be the same, you use address A, they are coming out to be the same, but they are in different segments. Okay, so they are only different addresses. Even though their physical addresses appear to be the same, they are different physical locations. Even though their logical addresses appear to be the same. Use AND A to check doesn't help. You check it, you will find that they are and A is the same. What is the meaning of virtual address are the same? I don't know what is virtual address. That is a good thing, Gyan, which has done it. Every person should try it. if basically it was referring to the same place, one of the outputs should be 7, but it doesn't happen. Outputs are only 6. What is this fork equal to 0? Pranav, from where you have got this? If fork equal to 0, then make an update. Till now I have not taught to you from where you have got it, though correct. You have got it correct, but from where you have got it. Okay. Let us see this.
Sir, so like how it copies the address even?
You see, basically address is also computed, but you see different two addresses calculated as you might have seen. Are you an old student of mathematics?
No, sir.
No, you are a new student.
Yeah.
You see that two addresses basically start segment address plus within that local segment address. So local segment address is the same, but actual physical address becomes different. Is it correct? Yes.
Okay, sir.
Is it all right to you? Yes. So you run this program. You will find that if there were only one A, then either parent or the child will make the value of A as 7 and another will make the value of A as 9. So something like 9 should come as an output. But you see, it does not give you any output like 9. On the other hand, when you see the address of A by parent and child, they turn out to be the same. So the physical address of age in parent and child are different, though logical address are the same. Because how a logical address is converted to a physical address by adding the start address of the segment. Is it correct? What is the problem? Any doubt? You run this program. Both parent and child is printing the value of A as 7. No one is printing at 9. Technically speaking, second value should be 9. What is the address? Address is the same. Slowly and slowly, I will be teaching you. Is it correct? Mostly in the theory class. When we shall different the virtual address and physical address in theory class sometimes, then it will become clear. Because from the today's point of view, it is not so important. Is it correct? Yes. Since the question was asked, so I explained it to you. Is it correct? Yes. any doubt till now? Any doubt? Yes, it is really true. You see, in systems programming course, you were talked about this offset. What was the offset? An address within the segment. Is it correct? So in code segment, in data segment, same address can refer to different things. Do you remember this kind of thing, Aviraj? Address A values are the same, but their physical locations are different. Then forget about it. Okay. If we do this, we shall be diverting too much from the today's topic. Is it correct? Yes. So if you are really interested, you send me a mail related to this. Then we can individually discuss. Okay, yes, huh? You try to say that I want to understand the difference between virtual address and physical address. Is it correct? Then we shall do this. Now, we come back here. What I mean to say by this example, that all values are copied into a child, that's all. Now let us proceed. Yes, certainly there will be a limit. Okay. And if we try to make false in a loop, sometimes the problem start coming. Is it correct? Yes, there will be a limit. So you write a program for I equal to 1 to 100 fork and you will face difficulty. Yes. Let us observe the output of this program and try to understand what are A's and B's. Is it correct? And how we can differentiate between parent and child using this program? Execute this program, observe its output. Also give me the answer, maybe that without execution, what are A and B? What is A and what is B? Can if you can give me the answer of this without typing this program, it will be very good. Wrong. Juman, wrong. We said, I am coming to that only. Slowly and slowly, I am coming. How to control the death of parent? I am coming on that. Slowly and slowly. Good. Good answer by Gyan. Now I want to know what is A and what is B. Better answer you would have written child followed by parent of child. It may be main or it may be one. What is A and what is B in this program? Good thing, others. Very good answer. Correct. Others, you are fully correct. A is also get paid and B is also get paid. How and when A and B are different? Fully correct, Aviraj. You see, I am asking one question from all of you. A and B are both get paid. How and A and B are sometimes different and sometimes same? There is a thing which I want to ask from you. Okay, we shall have a 5-minute break. What is 0000, Abhishek? Abhishek, I cannot understand it. Abhishek, I cannot at all understand you. 5-minute break. Now we see. A and B are both get paid. Why A and B are different? Can anyone answer this question? Why A and B are different? That is correct, Aditya. That is correct. Very good thing. A is created only once and a copy is made. But while B is created two times. Do you agree another thing that for parent, A and B will be the same. But for child, A and B will be different. Do you agree? Yes. A and B are same for parent, same for male, different for child. So, let us further proceed.
And we can see A is always main, B is either main or child, and it is their identifiers. If A equal to B, then can you tell me what will be the output of this program? Type the output of this program. This method we are using to differentiate between the parent and child. Previously, we were seeing that both parents and child were printing the same letter. But now we can make parent to make to print K and the child make print to L. How? Write a program
there. Parent prints. A and child L. Yes, correct. Correct. Why? Because the value of A and B are the same in parent only. That is correct. The program illustrates the order of the main and child process that IDs of A and B would be same if and only B is parent, otherwise B's ID will be child ID. So the different printing letters K and L, yeah, that is correct. Aditya, you are fully correct. Is it correct? Yes, fully correct. Now, you should also try to tell what will be the output of this program and when output will be created. Do this for this program also. What this program does, in which order output comes in this program. Nilanjan, have you executed it or you are telling without execution? Without a very good thing. Without, very good. Observing the sleep time, yes. What is happening here? Parent prints U and V. Child prints. Parent prints at time t equal to 1 and t equal to 3. Child prints at time t equal to 0 and time t equal to 2. Any doubt? You can even execute it. Now we shall see how the parent changes in a controlled manner. Previously, it was uncontrolled. There was a race condition. Yes. Now you try to understand. Tell me what is the output of this program. Previously, parent change was unsynchronized. Sometimes something, sometimes something. Now everything is controlled. Can you understand it? Good thing. Great answer. Do you understand why? Correct. Harshvardhan, very good answer. Very good answer. Others should also be understanding it and now you execute it. That is correct. Main process ends at time t equal to 1 and at time t equal to 2, t is getting printed. That is correct. And at time t equal to 2, 2 is getting printed, t is getting printed where the father is changed. So is your doubt of adaptation is clear now? Have you understood what is adaptation? Or any question you can ask now related with adaptation? Any question? Very good. Previously, you may be having many questions, but now you ask any question related with adaptation. Now, any question related with father change or any question of any type, we have identified A equal to B means father. A equal to B means father. The father dies at time t equal to 1. And at time t equal to 0, child prints L. His father is actual father. And at time t equal to 2, its father is a changed father. Simple. Any doubt now? Maybe that previously you might were asking many questions. Any question, doubt now? Any question now? Certainly, yes, concurrent processing, fully correct. Yes, we have assumed concurrent processing, fine. Yes, any other doubt? Yes, because theoretically means we are assuming two different processors. Is it correct? We are assuming two different processors. Okay. But there are not two different processors. There is a single processor. The single processor does sometimes the work of a parent and sometimes it does the work of a child. Is it correct? Yes. Do you understand it? Theoretically, we assume that when child is created, a different computing unit is assigned to a child. Anything else? Any more doubt?
आपको तीन
Now tell me the output of this program without execution. And give me the reason also. Give region also, Tanmay. I want the region also.
Hello.
That is correct, Tanmay. Tanmay, I want your roll number. Very good answer which you have given. Yes. While loop ensures that parent will be dying, so the way father should change. Is it correct? Harshvardhan, have you executed it? That is correct. Harshvardhan and Aviraj. Also type your roll number for the previous thing. Harshvardhan and Aviraj. Now, any doubt? Now, I want a computer program from you. Write smallest size computer program. Write program. Parent prints. H. Child prints. M. H is printed. M is printed after H. Can you write a program of this type? The smallest program. Let me see who can write it.
You see, Nilanjan, what was happening in while part? What is A? A is the ID of main. And what child does? Child is checking its father. When its father is different from the main, it comes out of the loop. Do you understand it? And prints I. When the father of child is different from the main, when the main dies. When the main will die? The main will die after printing V. What is your doubt, you tell me? Now you tell me what is your doubt. No. Gyan, you are wrong. H and M can be printed in any order. H and M can be printed in any order. Yes. Can you do it, Nikhil, without sleep? Can you do it without sleep? Harshvardhan, do without sleep. Good thing. Do without sleep. Do without sleep. You are doing opposite, Abhiraj. H will be printed after, H will be coming after M. You are doing opposite, Abhiraj. Do without sleep. Yes, we can use A not equal to B also. No, where we can use A not equal to B? Shobhit Misra, where we can use A not equal to B? In which line? It is not clear to me, Shobhit. Yes, Bagh. Subhajit Bagh. But there is no H in this program, yes. Bera and Subhajit Bagh. Type your roll number. Sohadip Bera. Sohadip Bera. Subhajit Bagh, Nilanjan Das, type your roll number. Sohadip Bera, age 18, ME 31034. Subhajit Bagh is 19CH10054. Subhajit Bagh. 55 is Nilanjan. Correct. Gyan also gave it correct. Utkars. No wrong. Utkars, you are wrong. You see, A not equal to B will hold for the child. So it will be printing M. Yes, Utkars is also correct. Utkars is also correct. Yes. Utkars, type your roll number, Utkars Sinha. Oh, sorry. Yes, I made a mistake. Nilanjan is 59. And Utkars Sinha. Fine. 18 ME. Correct. Das Gupta, you are also correct. Das Gupta, you also type your roll number. Yes. Fine. Now we have seen a method. How can a child wait for the death of its parent? But now we want to see a method by which parent can wait till its child dies. Okay, Tanmay is also correct. Yes, yes, yes. Aparna and Tanmay, you also type your own number. Aparna and Tanmay, yes, you are correct. Okay. Forty-seven and 07. Yes. Now we see another method. Here we see that the child was waiting for the death of its parent. Now we see how parent can wait till his child dies. No, suppose you don't want to go. No, you see, we would like that. Suppose you don't want to observe, do something without sleep. Is it correct? Okay, now. Can you write a program? Parent prints H, child prints M. H is printed, M is printed before H. No sleep. Can you write a program by this? Okay. How we can write this program? What is the output of this program observed by experimentation? What is the output of this program? Try to understand it by experimentation. Is it correct? Yes.
आप Hello.
Observe the output of this. You may experiment it. Gyan wrong. You don't have common sense. Gyan. Fully wrong. You have simply executed it and typing it. I want you can type, but apply your common sense also. Wrong. Till now, no satisfactory answer. Till now, no satisfactory answer. Wait for what, Harshvardhan? Wait for what? You see, what is the mistake? At time t equal to 0, v and g can be printed in any order. No, you execute it. W is also printed. At t equal to 0, B and G in any order. At t equal to 2, H is printed. H. And at t equal to 2, W is printed after H. Region. It means wait for no. Parent, wait till your child dies. What is the meaning of wait? It means wait till your child died. That is correct, Utkars. Is it correct? Yes. Have you understood it? No, you see, sometimes it could be VG, sometimes it could be GV. Is it correct? By chance, it is getting out as VG. But theoretically speaking, it can be anything. Is it the case? Theoretically speaking, it can be anything. Is this all right? I have told give theoretical answer after experimentation. Yes. Any doubt? No, who told you this? Parent starts before child, there is no rule. Nilanjan, what are you trying to do?
Sir, I simply put return 0.
Yes. Let us study the concept of return 0 also. Yes. You are fully correct. Let us study the concept of VG and wait and return 0. Let us see this. Let us study this. Yes, we should study return 0 also. You see VGSW is coming?
Return 0 has no effect. Child continues.
Sir, but when I am executing it, still now it is showing VG. Just now it became HW. Like for long time it was VG.
No, VG. For long time it will be VG for 2 seconds. Because at time t equal to 2, H will be coming. Then the W will be printed. Is it correct? So some long, not long time, 2 second time. No? Wrong, Harshvardhan bhai? Wait in else, shows error. Wait in else will show error. We shall see the reason behind it. Child will wait for what? But child has no process for which it can wait. No, there is no error in this. There is no error. There is no error. No, it is not showing error. No, you check it. It is not showing error. No error. Yes. Any doubt till now? Now, we have seen a method. Can you write a proof? We have seen a method that parent prints A, child print B in any order. Two, in any order. Child print B and grandchild prints C. In any order we are interested. Can someone write a program for this? Parent prints A, child prints B, and grandchild prints C. How we can write a program for this?
Can you shorten this program? Nilanjan is correct. Tanmay is also correct. Gyan. Why have you used weight? Why have you used weight? If B equal to C, then weight. No need of weight. Who is this person? Maji is correct. Others. You see, acha, you are okay. What are you creating others? You are creating four process. Maybe that you are correct, but certainly inefficient. Utkarsh. Utkarsh. Print of A, very good thing, Utkars. In the beginning itself, we can print A. B equal to get paid. If A is not equal to get paid, then print B for she equal to get paid. If C is not equal to B, print C. Utkars, I want your all number. The smallest answer. Gyan, but you already wrote it. Why are you writing it two times? Tanishq. Yes, fine. Utkarsh 33. Okay, fine. We stop here. If you want to ask any doubt, you ask me. We stop here. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Aviraj, Nikhil, let me see the people. Tanishq. Yes. Any doubt? Otherwise, we stop here. Stop here. Any doubt? Any doubt? Yes. Mahajan. Mahajan, yes, you are correct. You can execute them. Nikhil, why are you doing it two times? Any doubt? Any person has any doubt? Otherwise, our class is over. Subhajit Mishra. Yes, correct. You can execute it and test it. And I have sent, Mishra, I have sent an assignment to you. Have you got it? You can discuss any doubt, otherwise class is over.
So can you share the notepad where we wrote all the codes today in the class?
Notepad mein to humne sare notes hata diye. Dalte chale gaye, hatate chale gaye, theek hai? Kuch doubts clear kar sakte hain abhi abhi yahi pe, theek hai? Yes. Acha stop. Recording bhi to ki thi, recording bhi ki thi. Yes or no?
Yes, sir, just kabhi kabhi revise karna hota na ki just class mein kya kya hua tha to wo.